worship you. We worship you. Thank you for your presence. Thank you for your presence. Thank you for your presence. We love you, Father God. We honor you, Lord. Hallelujah. 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 Heal your people today. Heal your people, Holy Spirit. Heal. Touch them, Jesus. Heal your people, Jesus, today. Heal all of us, Lord. Heal our hearts. Heal our bodies. Heal our minds, heal our souls, Jesus. We receive your total healing, Jesus. We receive your love, we receive your mercy, we receive your power, oh God. We receive your healing power, oh God. We receive your healing power. We receive your healing power. We receive, say, Lord, I receive your healing power. I receive your healing power. I receive your healing power. Open your mouth. Open your mouth and declare, I receive your healing power. I receive your healing power. I receive my healing. I receive my healing by faith. I receive my healing. I receive my health. I receive my restoration. I receive, Lord. I receive. We receive. We receive. Thank you for healing your people. Thank you for healing your people. We receive. We receive our long life, oh God. We receive your provision. We receive your grace. We receive your provision. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. We receive your joy, oh God. We receive your joy, oh God. We receive our strength. We receive our healing. We receive our restoration, oh God. The joy of the Lord is our strength. The joy of the Lord is our strength. We receive our strength. We receive our provision. We receive our provision. We receive. We receive from heaven. We receive our miracles, Lord. We receive our miracles, Lord. We receive our brand new hearts. We receive our brand new lungs. We receive our brand new kidneys, oh God. We receive, Lord, in the name of Jesus, whatever is needed in our bodies, Lord. We receive from heaven. We receive from heaven. In the name of Jesus, we receive our body parts. We receive, Lord. We receive from heaven. Let the angels of God bring us. The angels of the Lord, in Jesus' name, bring us. Our prayers, our prayer requests, bring them to us. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Let all your needs be met. Let all your needs be provided. Let all your needs be provided. Let all your needs be provided. Receive your healing. Receive your miracles. Miracles, 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 miracles be upon all of you. We receive our miracles. We receive our miracles, Lord. We receive our miracles. In the name of Jesus. Lord, baptize them in the Holy Spirit. Those who are not yet baptized, Lord, fill them. Fill them. Fill them. Yes, fill them with the Holy Spirit. Now you are healed. The Lord says all your troubles are answered. All your prayers are answered. things you have given what is due to me, now I am giving you what is due to you. Receive your miracle. Receive your miracle. Receive your miracle. Receive your miracle. Receive the answer to your prayers. Receive the answer to your prayers. Jesus is able. He says, I am willing. Jesus says, I am willing. I am willing. Receive by faith. Say, I receive, Lord, the answers to my prayers. I receive my miracles. I receive my miracles, Lord. I receive my miracles. I receive the answers to my prayers. I receive my miracles. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Holy Spirit, thank you for baptizing your people, oh God. Thank you for baptizing your people, oh God. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Thank you. He is the God who supplies all your needs according to His riches and glory by Christ. He is our El Shaddai, the God who is more than enough. 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 The supreme provider of everything we need. Thank you, Jesus, for visiting us tonight. Thank you, Jesus. Lord, we pray that you always visit us, Lord. We pray, oh God, that you're always here with us, your presence be always with us, oh Lord. Truly, Lord, you are the only one we need, Jesus. You are the only one we need, Lord Jesus. You are the only one we need. And you're the answer to all our troubles, Jesus. You're the answer to all our needs, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. We love you, Jesus. We love your presence. 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 We love your presence, Jesus. We love your presence. Holy Spirit, we love your presence. Sweet Holy Spirit, we love your presence. We love your presence, Holy Spirit. We love your presence. We love your presence, Holy Spirit. Father, thank you for the Holy Spirit. And thank you for sending your Son Jesus this afternoon in our church, Lord. Thank you, thank you, thank you, Father. 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 Praise your holy name. Hallelujah. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Bless your holy name. Thank you, Lord. 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 Jesus is the only answer to our troubles, to our problems. Amen. Amen. Always come to the presence of the Lord. This is where the answer is. This is where the answer is. Praise God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise your holy name. Praise your holy name. Hallelujah. The title of our message for today is Looking Beyond the Horizon. We always base our faith, our actions, our emotions on what we can see. But there is something out there beyond the horizon. Put it on the screen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Are you ready now?
Amen.
Praise you, Jesus. Say, I am blessed.
I am blessed.
I am healed.
I am healed.
I am well provided.
I am well provided.
I am highly favored.
I am highly favored.
I am glorious.
I am glorious.
I am victorious.
I am victorious.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Today, I will listen to the word of God.
The word of God.
Therefore,
I will be blessed.
You will be blessed.
You will be blessed.
Everyone will be blessed.
Everyone
beyond
blessed.
Measure.
Beyond
in Jesus' name,
in Jesus
everybody
name.
Say,
Amen.
Give the Lord a clap of praise. Praise God. Hallelujah. I want you to shake hands with your brothers and sisters left and right. Give them a big smile. Praise God. And tell them, thank you for coming today. You bless my life. Praise God. Hallelujah. The Bible says, we are more than a conqueror.
Amen.
No problem, no trouble, no sickness, no whatever challenge you are facing right now has the ability to defeat you. Only if you allow them. But the Bible says you are more than a conqueror. Meaning to say, you are the winner already. Amen po.
Amen.
You are the winner already. God never lose any battle.
Amen.
And if God is for us,
who
can be against us? Therefore, we will not lose any battle in our lives.
Amen.
It's just a matter of time. The problem is there for just a short time. But if you keep on believing and fighting and fighting and praying and, you know, praising God for the answer, the problem will suddenly disappear.
Amen.
It will shrink and shrink and shrink and disappear. It has no power against the name of Jesus.
Amen.
The name of Jesus is supreme.
Amen.
The name of Jesus is supreme.
Amen.
Just keep on declaring the name of Jesus over your trouble. Your trouble will eventually shrink and disappear. You say, in the name of Jesus, my problem, you're gone. In the name of Jesus, you will not win against me. In the name of Jesus, I'm victorious over you. In the name of Jesus, 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 there's power in that name.
Amen.
There's power in that name. Every knee will bow and every tongue will confess in heaven, on earth, and under the earth. And will declare that Jesus is Lord to the glory of God the Father. So the problem will declare that Jesus is Lord, really. I surrender. The problem will surrender. Amen. There's power in the name of Jesus. We just need to open our mouth and declare, release the power, release the anointing, release your faith in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
Release your faith in the name of Jesus. Let's go to the book of Joshua chapter 10. Looking beyond the horizon. You know what the horizon is?
Amen.
Joshua chapter 10. Who lives in Manila?
Amen.
Who knows the Rojas Boulevard?
Amen.
You know the place?
Amen.
Sino ang nagde-date doon sa gilid ng Rojas Boulevard?
Dati, Pastor.
Dati. Pag walang pera. When you have no money, you go beside the beach and you look at the horizon. You look at the beautiful sunset, Pastor Mark. With your loved one beside you. Don't quarrel, you might push you on the water. So you always see the horizon, okay? You don't see anything else, you see the horizon. Most of the people thought, especially in those previous days, that the horizon is the end of the earth. That beyond this thing, beyond these places, when you reach that places, you will just suddenly fall. But one person, whose name is Christopher Columbus, looks beyond the horizon. And by courage and by faith, he travels on and on and goes and on until he reaches the horizon and he didn't fail. He found out that the earth is round.
Amen.
And he discovered many countries that we know right now, especially America and many other places. And this opens for the opportunity for the gospel to be spread throughout the world. Christopher Columbus is a Christian. He was used by the Lord to discover the unknown world. He discovered America, he discovered South America, he discovered many places. And after these places were discovered, Christianity started to creep in and goes into this place. God has always a way how to reach places, people, and he has always the way how to solve our problems.
Amen.
Have you heard the testimony of Query last night?
Amen.
Amen.
Okay. God works in a very miraculous, unexplainable way.
Amen.
So here in our story, God says to Joshua, be courageous as a Christian to defeat the enemy and to win the battle. We must be courageous, brave, strong, brave, strong in faith. What did God say to Joshua? Be strong and be courageous. Why? Because the Lord is with us. The Lord is our shield. He's our protector. He's our... Actually, the Lord fights the battle for us.
Amen.
We have such a huge project, 50 million pesos. For us, we are not rich people. 50 million is a big money. Yes, to the millionaires, this is nothing. But if you have big faith, and if you have courage, 50 million pesos becomes smaller and smaller and smaller and smaller until your faith becomes bigger and bigger and bigger over the problem. And when it happens, praise God, this is now the chance for God to move over this situation. God will provide everything we need.
Amen.
Maybe right now you're wondering, Pastor Ben, how can we accomplish that huge, huge project? 50 million pesos, I don't even have 100,000 pesos in my bank account. But if you are God, you are on top of the world, and you own everything, what is 50 million pesos?
Amen.
Amen.
Amen?
That's just a pocket change to rich people. What God needs from us is faith.
Amen.
Strong faith. Trusting in God and keeps on walking by faith every day. We trust God every day. When Joshua was given the assignment, he's going to defeat, I think, more than 30 nations or 30 cities in Canaan. God says, I have given you the country. I have given you the promised land. But you will have to put some action. You will have to defeat the enemies. I will not defeat the enemy for you, but I am going to assist you. I am going to help you. But it's you yourself who will have to fight the battle. But God gave Joshua encouragement. Be courageous and be strong, because I will never leave you. I will never forsake you. In any battle you have, I will be with you. Amen. Hallelujah. Any battle you have, any battle you face, the Lord is always with you.
Amen.
Whatever it is, just be courageous, be strong in the heart, be strong in the heart.
Amen.
Be courageous, be strong in the heart. Amen. Your little problem is nothing to Jesus.
Amen.
Praise God. Tell your neighbor, be strong in your heart.
Amen.
God will even stop the sun and the moon from moving. Hallelujah. Can you imagine that? He will stop the cycle of the universe just to help you. And this is what happened here in this story. He stopped the sun from going down. Joshua chapter 10. Now Adoni-Zedek, king of Jerusalem, heard that Joshua had taken Ai and totally destroyed it. doing, okay, destroy it, doing to Ai and its king as he had done to Jericho and its king, and that the people of Gibeon had made a treaty of peace with Israel and were living near with them. So God says, okay, you will enter the promised land if you will just obey every instruction I'm gonna give you. You will win the battle. So the first battle of Joshua is the battle of what? Jericho. You know the story?
Amen.
Jericho is fortified, walled, surrounded by huge, large, and tall wall. And they have developed army. Strong army. The Israelites were shepherds. They have no training. They were in the desert. They have no weapons. Actually, their weapons are just not really that strong and effective. But God says, you just follow my instruction, we will defeat Jericho. What did God say? You march around Jericho. First day, they march around Jericho. Lord, what are we doing? Second day, you march again around Jericho. They march again around Jericho city. And they did it 6 days.
Amen.
If you're one of the soldiers, what would you think? Lord, what are we doing here? We are watching. We are marching and doing nothing. And the walls are so high and so huge, full of armies with effective weapons. And here we are, we have shepherds that came from the desert, mga matitigas sa ulong shepherd. How can we defeat this? But Joshua still followed the instruction of God. And God says, on the seventh day, you will have to turn around 7 times.
Amen.
Lord, we're so tired already. If we do that for 7 times, just 1 time makes us very tired already. And now you want us to march 7 times? God is depleting their weakness and their strength so that they will not say when they defeated Jericho, it is through my strength that we defeat Jericho. No! God usually comes in the point where we have no more strength, no more health, no more resources, then God suddenly will say, here I am! Praise God! On the time when you have no more strength, when you have no more money, when you have no more health, when you exhausted all your resources, that is the time where God will appear and says, here I am! Let me prove to you that I am your God, I am your shield, I am your provider. We will defeat your enemy!
Yes.
Didn't you notice that? God comes during the time when you have no more resources, no more strength, no more hope. To prove to you that it is not you who did the miracle for you, or not your strength or beauty or intelligence that helped you accomplish all these things. That it is God alone.
Amen.
He gets all the glory. He gets all the glory. So they enter Jericho. They enter the land of the promise, the Canaan land. They follow the instruction of God. On the seventh day, they march 7 times. 7 times under the heat of the sun here in Saudi Arabia. In the Middle East, it's so hot. Can you imagine we're marching outside? The whole Riyadh for 7 times? I think many of us will not make it. Many will collapse, will fail, will surrender. Oh, dito na lang kay Baal, walang marching. I just worship Baal, there's no marching here. Jehovah, so many requirements. Why? It's very difficult. Didn't the disciples of Jesus, some disciples, they went away? They said, this is a very difficult teaching. Why? Jesus says, unless you eat my flesh and drink my blood, you cannot ever be saved.
Amen.
You can never be saved. And the weak disciple says, This is a very difficult teaching. They scratched their head and went away. Some of the instructions of the Lord are not easy. But keep on marching forward.
Amen.
Marching forward. Yes, they're difficult. Keep on marching forward. So on the seventh day, they marched 7 times under the heat of the sun, Pastor Henry, under the heat of the sun. 7 times. And on the 7th round, they will give a great shout. How can you shout when you're so tired already? Look at the requirements of God. If we analyze the requirements of God, you're so tired, you have no more perspiration, you exhausted all your perspiration, hindi ka na pumapawis. Dugo na lumalabas sa'yo. You're perspiring your blood already, right? Because you're so tired, it's so hot, you're so drained, you're so dehydrated. And still the Lord says, on the last round, 7th round, you will have a shout, a very loud shout. How can you shout when you're so drained? But still, they follow the instruction. What happened when they followed the instruction? They shout, Hallelujah! And the walls collapse, Hallelujah! Enter Jericho and destroy everything. Destroy the male, the female, the babies, all the livestock and the king. Destroy them, kill them, destroy them, kill them, destroy them. Ayan, praise God, may trumpet pa. But we will have to follow God's instructions.
Amen.
To win the battle. So here, Joshua has defeated Ai. After defeating Jericho, they defeated Ai. Praise God. Joshua is the best general who ever lived in the history of mankind. He defeated more than 30 kings without losing a single battle. Joshua didn't lose a single battle. He is the best general who ever lived. So if you are aspiring to be a general, a military general, read the book of Joshua. Read the book of Joshua. And you will win every battle. ISIS, read the book of Joshua. Abu Sayyaf, read the book of Joshua. If you're a general, they need our advice. You know. They need the Christian's advice. They could not defeat Abu Sayyaf, ilang piraso lang yan. They could not defeat the rebels. How many rebels there? 100, 200. And still the rebels keep on getting people and beheading people. Why? No focus, no continuity, and no prayer. No word of God, no prayer, no guidance from the Lord. They made you a general? Let's fast and pray. What are we going to do, Mr. President? I want you to wipe out Abu Sayyaf. In 3 months, Mr. President will wipe them out in 3 weeks. But we need to pray and fast for the first 1 week. What do we say when we pray? Lord, blind them in the name of Jesus. We send the angels of God in the name of Jesus. Blind them, confuse them in the name of Jesus. Give them fever, give them headache, give them leprosy, every one of them in the name of Jesus. When you pray like that for 1 week, fasting and prayer, all the opposite will just come out. We surrender, we're full of leprosy. We don't know where this thing came from. There's no leprosy in the Philippines. Now we are full of leprosy. But I could not defeat Abu Sayyaf. They bought airplanes from South Korea. They give that money to our church as a love offering. We defeat Abu Sayyaf. We pray every day that they got blind. In 3 months, they're all blind.